I'll be in the barber shop. I get pissed off. Okay. I'm ready. Hello guys, my name, welcome back to my world. Welcome back to Coast Coast with me, Osina Gamando. So now, Sanja, before I can get to today's topic, I want to say good luck to class of 2020. I know this year has been the hardest for you, and I know that Nibekezele, you have endured the most out of Wongonyakabaka grade 12. You have been the ones abathole ubunzima kakhulu compared to abanye onyaka. So I want to say good luck and enjoy this moment. I know that you might be nervous because usoyiki outcomes, because maybe you think you did not study enough, but I want to say enjoy this moment. It only comes once. Enjoy it and yeah, just be yourself, ubhale iphepha lakho, and I promise everything will work out the way it is supposed to work out. So with that out of the way, good luck class of 2020. I love you so much. So namhlanje ke, I will be doing a book versus the movie comparison, and the book that we will be doing that with is Chimamanda Ngozi's Half of a Yellow Sun. So before we can get to that, I want to say congratulations to Chimamanda Ngozi. She has won another award for this amazing book. So she won a Winner of Winners award, a Fumana from Booker's Prize. I think it's Booker's Prize, yeah. So she won the award for this amazing book. And I will be doing the movie book comparison with it. If you're interested in that, continue watching. Let's talk Nigeria in a mass hysteria. Yeah, our souls are brought together so that we could love. So before I can give you the comparison, my comparison of the book and the movie, I want to give you a little synopsis of the book. So this is a historical fiction, firstly. So historical fiction is means that this book is based on true events. Something did happen. It's just that the writer created characters to carry the book or to carry the story. So this book is about a civil war that happened in Nigeria in 1967 until 1970. The war was between the Hausa people, I hope I pronounced that well, was between the Hausa people and the Igbo tribe, which led the Igbo people to move from Nigeria. Not entirely move from Nigeria, but to move to a different direction where they created their own independent state, and they called it Biafra. So the war lasted for 3 years, and the country, or the independent country, also lasted for 3 years. And this book starts in the early 60s, where the narrator takes us to where we meet Ugu with his master. We are introduced to 13-year-old Ugu. And then the book takes us to the mid-60s when the war started. And then it takes us in the late 60s in the aftermath of the war in 1970. We have 5 amazing characters that carried this book. We have Ugu, who is a houseboy, who turns to a cook, who turns to a soldier, who also turns to an author. And we have Odenibo, who is a professor at Nsuka University. We have Olana, who's from a Wella family, who is a beautiful young woman who is the girlfriend of Odenibo, but also becomes his wife later on. And we have Richard is a English boy, if I can put it that way. He's from England. He comes to Nigeria for his interest in Igbo Ugu art. I hope I pronounced that well. He has a dream to write about that art piece. And yeah, and then we have Kainene, who is my favorite character in the book. Kainene is Olana's twin sister, but they are completely opposites. Kainene she has a dry sense of humor. She is calculative. She is a no-nonsense taker. she's like independent. She wants to do things on her accord, and she doesn't care if she impresses anybody, or she's not looking for, I know, assurance or anything. She is comfortable in her own skin. She doesn't give like a F, if I can put it that way. So that's Kainene. She was my favorite character in this book because somehow I had a connection with her. Yeah, in a way. Yeah, so she was my favorite character. The themes that carried this book were the war, obviously, politics, relationships, since there were like a lot of relationships being built and a lot of relationships between Dignibo and Olana, relationship with Richard and Kainene, and also like family relationships or relationships that were happening because of the war. This was an amazing book. I loved it. I enjoyed it. It is one of my favorites. I've always thought my favorite book by Chimamanda Ngozi will forever be Americana, but this was also like a beautiful book, and I get why she has won numerous awards for this book. It is an amazing book. It is a beautiful book. And for me, for someone who knows about Nigeria but do not know the total history of the Nigerians, it was the first time I've ever heard that there was a civil war in Nigeria, and that there was a state called Biafra that lasted for 3 years. So it is insightful. It is also educational. You will learn about the history of Nigeria, also about the culture of Nigerians, and also about how things were and how there's still a tension between the Hausa people and the Igbo people in Nigeria, because there's still that like, this happened, I don't really, really like you. But I feel like Nigerian people are working towards having like unity and having peace, and also acknowledging that they have issues and also coming up with solutions on how to work around those issues. So I am happy that I read this book. So now let's get to the movie. Firstly, I want to know who authorized the release of that movie. Like, who are the people who went to the cinema and watched that movie and felt like, yes, this is the movie? Like, who did that? Why was that movie released? Why does that movie exist? Guys, the disrespect of this amazing book, the disrespect, the waste of money, the waste of good actors. Rubbish. That movie, rubbish. Don't play with my imagination. Do not play with my imagination. Let's start with the characters. We have Odenibo, Olana. Okay, cool. I'm cool with Odenibo. I like the guy who played Odenibo. I like the Tendi Newton for Olana. But the lady who played Kainene. No. Guys, no. Onika, you are an amazing actress, but not for Kainene. My imagination for Kainene looked like the lady who plays a queen in Queen and Slim. For me, that was my Kainene. That is my Kainene. No, guys. No. And then Ugu. Ugu, guys. Why? Ugu looked like he was 27. Just from the get-go, he looked like he was 27. Ugu is introduced as a 13-year-old. And then came that guy. Why? And then on top of everything else, they did not feature him as the soul of the book. Because Ugu is the soul of that book. The book starts with him and it ends with him. He is the eyes and the ears of the book. Like, Ugu carried that book. Ugu carried this book. And in that movie, it just appeared. Like, you don't get him, like, in the movie. You don't get, what is he doing? Like, Oh! Why did they make that movie? Why? Oh my god. Like, I don't get it. Why did they make that movie? And then, what else? Because there's so much missing. There's a lot of characters that they did not include in that movie. There's a lot of scenes. There's a lot of things. A lot of chapters that were missing. A lot of everything that was missing in that movie. That movie was a flop. A flop, 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 flop. And Richard! Ah! Guys! You know, I've always told myself that never watch a movie that is based on a book, or I shouldn't watch a movie before I read the book if the movie is based on a book. So, but I broke that promise like a while back when I watched The Sun Is Also a Star. Beautiful movie. Like, from the get-go, I understood the movie. I got the concept. I got the plot. I got the structure of the movie. But half of a yellow sun, guys. Like, for somebody who has never read this book, like, I want to get it from your point of view. I want somebody who has never read this book to go and watch that movie. They have the movie on YouTube. You can get the movie there. Like, please watch that movie and please come back to me and tell me, like, what do you get from the movie? What do you understand from the movie? Like, except from what I told you, what the book is about. Like, just clear your mind of everything that I just said. Just go and watch the movie if you have never read the book. But if you have read this book, don't you dare. Don't you dare watch that movie. You will be disappointed for the rest of your life. Do not go and watch that movie. It is rubbish. Rubbish. Like, the time invested in creating rubbish. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry, guys. But I was really disappointed in that movie. I was really disappointed. Because for me, before I even watched it, I was like, imagining how it will look on screen, like from the first scene, like from when Ugu is coming from the village going to Odignibo's home. Like, I imagined him walking with his aunt. Like, I imagined that happening. Like, I saw the road, I saw everything, guys. And then tololo did not show, did not happen. Ugu was just like an extra in the movie, even though he's like the soul of this book. Other than that, great book. This should be read. This should be read. Everybody needs to read this. But stay away from the movie. Stay away from the movie. And if I was rating it, it would be 0 out of 5. Whereas the book would be 5 out of 5. So, yeah. That's that. So, yeah. Until next time. Be safe. Be kind. And spread a lot. And a lot. I mean, like, lots and lots. Bye-bye. Peace be still.